The relevant paragraphs from the affidavit must clarify my guilty in support of the application are one, that he is a member of parliament for a gallerist constituency and minister of the government and had the capacity to serve. Two, that on the 30th of December 2019, the then minister of local government, the docket I currently hold, tabled a motion for the creation of the city, Soroti City inclusive, with the competition standing to be determined after consultation with the relevant stakeholders. That the district chairperson confirmed to me that adequate consultations had been made by the councillors in their respective areas. Four, that the staff of the ministry and myself interacted with the residents of Arway and Ethiopia, who indicated their wish to remain in Soroti East, and that wishes of the people is a critical factor in determining the boundaries of our administrative unit. Five, that in such a notice I issued, which communicated the decision of government and parliament detailing the composition of the cities, Aloit Parish and Ubiyai Parish were part of Soroti East Division and not Soroti West Division. Six, that on the 17th day of September 2020, upon receiving petitions and letters from stakeholders seeking clarifications on the city division boundaries for Soroti City, I issued guidance and clarification on the position of government and parliament regarding the composition of administrative units of Soroti City. A copy of the same guidance is attached and marked annexed B. Seven, that I have been informed by the applicant that the clarification I issued was never brought to the attention of the High Court. Eight, that on 10th August 2020, at the inauguration of the city by Right Honorable Speaker of Parliament of the Republic of Uganda, in a special joint sitting of both the Soroti District Council and Soroti Municipal Council, I laid out the boundaries as approved by government, whereupon the stakeholders in attendance endorsed without any voice of dissent. That I was never notified of the proceedings in civil suit number 29 of 2020, under which the judgment and orders were made, so as to give guidance support on the matter as the Prime Minister. 10. That the decision of the court has the same effect of altering the lawful and legal resolution of Parliament as informed by the decisions of the Cabinet and the District Council on the composition of Soroti City. 11. That I am aware that any alteration of the boundaries of the city or local division can only be done with the approval of Parliament as per Section 7, Subsection 7 of the Local Government Act. 12. That the opposition as portrayed in the instant application and supporting affidavit of the applicant portrays the true effort of the position of cabinet and parliament on the composition of Soroti City and its divisions. 13. That I swear this affidavit in support of the application for review of the judgment and the orders in civil suit number 29 of 2020 and remedies there. For the respondents, Mr. Simon Peter Edoru, LOC 5, Chairperson Eric, Soroti District, saw an affidavit in reply. The pertinent paragraphs are 4, 9, 10, 11, 14, 15, and 19. And for avoidance of doubt, I shall reproduce them. Paragraph 4. That I was present on August 10, 2020. In a joint district council and municipal council meeting during the launch of the city by Honorable Kadata, Speaker of Parliament and Honorable Rafael Madezi, Minister of Local Government. 9. That according to the Minister guidelines as read out by Honorable Madezi, the East Division is comprised of Eastern Division, Northern Division, Aquin, Achin, Queen Parish, Okuyo Parish, Owarei Parish of Soroti Sub County, Aloit Parish of Arapai Sub County, and Ukiai Parish in Soroti Sub County. 10. That the instruments, stroke guidelines, Soroti West Division is proposed to comprise of Western Division and Main Town Council, Arapai Town Council, and Akola Parish, and Agama Parish of Owarei Sub County. 11. That at the time the district passed the resolution in December 2019 and the instrument of stroke guidelines were made in June 2020, Aloit Parish of Arapai Sub County and Ukiai Parish of Soroti Sub County did not exist. 14. That Ukiai Village of Ameni Parish of Soroti Sub County became Ukiai Court of Ameni Town Council in 2018 when Ameni Town was created from Soroti Sub County in 2018. 15. That the instrument of guidelines placed the whole of our main town council, which of Ukiai Ward is part of, and the whole of our vital council, which Aloit Ward is part of in Soroti West Division. 19. That myself, together with the district speaker and other district council members, are shocked to see a letter from Honorable Akuni, the LOC 5 chairman, to the electoral commission without consultation, consent, or approval of the district council, purporting to make clarification of the electoral commission proposal. And suggesting transferring of Aloit and Ukiai towards what's from Soroti West to Soroti East. This clarification was irregularly done and should not be allowed to stand. As for the 6 correspondent, the Electoral Commission, Mr. Patrick Wetaka submitted that the Electoral Commission adheres to the statutory instrument and guidance of the minister dated 17 September 2020, also concluded that the Electoral Commission 6 respondent has always complied with the order of the court. This court has carefully considered the pleadings on both sides as far as the application for review of the ruling and orders in the High Court Civil Suit number 29 of 2020 is concerned. The law on review is now long settled, and Section 82 of the Civil Procedure Act provides any person considering himself or herself aggrieved by a decree or order from which an appeal is allowed by this Act, but from which no appeal has been filed, or by a decree or order from which no appeal is allowed by this Act, may apply for a review of judgment to the court which passed the decree or made the order, and the court may make such order on the decree or order as it seems fit. Order 46, Rule 4, and Rule 1A and B of the Civil Procedure also provide the same wording as Section 8 of the Civil Procedure Act, but provides further as to the conditions to be satisfied by one applying for a review. And it adds that at the proof from the discovery of new and important matter or evidence which, after the exercise of due diligence, was not within his or her knowledge or could not be produced by him or her at the time when the decree was passed or the order was made on account of some mistake or error apparent on the face of the record, or for any other sufficient reason, desires to obtain a review of the decree passed or order made against him may apply for the review of the judgment to which court, to the court which passed the decree of making a product. An appointed person for purposes of review is one who has suffered a legal grievance in the sense that such a person has direct interest in the matter which interest has been injuriously affected. In the case of Yusuf versus Noble Act, 1971, the subcarbon reports at page 104 is in point. Secondly, the applicant for review must show that there is a mistake or error apparent on the face of the record of the proceedings in the applicant's court that the court has determined or is determined. An error apparent to the face of record is one that is evident and its incorrectness does not require any extraneous matter by way of proof. It is so manifest and clear that no court of law exercising judicial power would allow it to remain unreported, as stated by the Supreme Court in Exxon versus Pastoral Members, Supreme Court Civil Appeal No. 6204. Turning to the circumstances of the present case, the applicant's case is that the Electoral Commission organized the elections in areas different from what was passed by Cabinet, Parliament, and published in the Gazette. The same state of affairs is attributed to the error made by this court in removing the word of Aloint and of PI from Soroti City East to Soroti City West. Mr. Simon Peter Edouard, who in his affidavit reply does not deny or challenge the applicant's assertion, but gives uncoordinated history of administrative units in Soroti City West. That information was not of any assistance to this application. Instead, the 60th respondent acknowledges that they only organized elections in the altered locations in compliance with the court order, but concedes that the proper electoral areas, as presented by the applicant on the affidavit in support of the applicant application by Rafael Magesi and the attached Uganda Gazette under statutory notice 2020, when it comes to boundaries and composition of Soroti East, Soroti City East, and Soroti City West. Under the Gazette, Soroti East comprises of Eastern Municipal Division, Northern Municipal Division, of Puyo Parish, Achueti, Queen Parish, Okiai Parish, Aloit Parish, and Otatai Parish. Then Soroti West comprises of Western Municipality Division, Amen A Ward, Amen B Ward, Oderai Ward, Rasai Ward, Amoru Ward, Arapai Ward, Akama Parish, and Akora Parish. Even in his letter dated 17 September 2020, attached to his affidavit, to the affidavit of the letter is addressed to the chairperson of the Electoral Commission and the attached to the affidavit of Rafael Magesi, the Minister of Local Government. It emphasized that no alterations regarding Soroti City boundaries had been made after the approval of the Parliament. We then stated the same as follows. Soroti East, Eastern Municipal Division, Northern Municipal Division, Okuyo Parish, Achueti Ken Parish, Soroti South County, Opiai Ward, formerly of Amen Town Council, Aloit Ward, formerly of Arapai Town Council, and Otatai Parish, formerly of Achueti South County. Soroti West, Western Municipal Division, Amen A Ward, Amen B Ward, Otera Ward, Oruata Ward, formerly of Amen Town Council, I'm moving on to somebody who are up by county council. I'm up by both to somebody who are up by county council. I come up by somebody who I live sub-county. And I put up by somebody who live sub-county. If such information has been brought to the attention of this court on 26th November 2020, it would then this court would not have placed a lawyer to work and appear in work under Soroti High Court Ruling. I agree with the counsel for the applicant that it was a contradiction with what was passed by Parliament of Uganda and published in the Uganda Gazette. That was no doubt a mistake or an error apparent on the face of the record. I therefore find that point that such an error is so manifest and clear that no court of law exercising its judicial power can allow it to remain on the record. This court mistakenly altered the instrument made by the Parliament. I therefore exercise this court's power under Section 82. And then an internine of the Civil Procedure Act and Section 33 of the Judiciary Act to allow this application. The judgment that ordered in Civil Suit number 29 of 2020 are reviewed and set aside. The words of Aroy and of PI are accordingly removed from Soroti City Division West and just back. And the Soroti Division East. Lastly, the electoral commission is to take such appropriate action in compliance with this right ruling. And each party needs help.
Thank you.